Okay, we're going to see if we can use the compressor theorem to show that the improper integral from 2 to infinity 1 over x squared minus 1 dx converges or not, right? And this is just going to be my attempt, and you'll see why in a minute. As usual, in order for us to use the compression theorem, we have to first come up with something that we know much better, right? So let me put down what we know, okay? And in this case, as you can see, we have 1 on the top only, and on the bottom, we have x squared minus 1. So let's just ignore the minus 1. So in another word, I'm just going to put down the integral from 2 to infinity, and I just want to focus on 1 over x squared dx, just like this. And this is a really straightforward improper integral, right? Because it's from the P theorem. So this right here is the P value is equal to 2. And you have to tell me 2 is greater than 1, because the moment that P is greater than 1, in the type 1 situation, when we have the infinite interval, this right here converges, right? Okay, the second step is that we are going to do the check. And the check is, I will put down this on the left-hand side, the integral from 2 to infinity, 1 over x squared minus 1 dx, and I will put down that on the right-hand side, so integral from 2 to infinity, 1 over x squared dx. Keep in mind, we are using a convergent, finite, right? And we hope to show that this is less than or equal to finite. That's the first situation here. So I'm going to set up this inequality, but I don't know if this is true or not. So I'm just going to put on a quotation mark. OK, focus on the functions only. So in other words, we have 1 over x squared minus 1. Is this less than or equal to 1 over x squared? Right here, we just care about when the x values are bigger than or equal to 2. And notice that when x is bigger than or equal to 2, both of these terms are positive, so I can indicate that right here. But anyways, we'll focus this right here real quick. Let's just go ahead and cross multiply, because you know positive, 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 right? So we can cross multiply, and we keep the same inequality symbol, right? Okay, 1 times x squared, we have x squared on the left-hand side. We write this down, less than or equal to, I don't know yet, technically. But the moment I do x squared minus 1 times 1, just x squared minus 1 on the right-hand side. What we're saying is, x squared, is this less than or equal to x squared minus 1? Well, I don't think so, right? Because you can cancel out the x squared, you get 0 is less than or equal to negative 1. That doesn't look right. This inequality here is clearly false. Once again, this right here is clearly false. And it's not because there was anything wrong for the setup. Be sure you still use the less than or equal to symbol right here to set up, okay? Because we're using a convergent. Unfortunately, this did not work out. This inequality is false. This means I cannot draw any conclusion. I cannot draw any conclusion from the comparison theorem. I cannot say this converge, I cannot say this diverge, I just cannot draw any conclusion at all, because this is false. So in that case, what do we do? Okay, so now, the deal is that sometimes when we worked out the comparison theorem, if this inequality didn't come out to be true, when we cannot draw a conclusion, of course, we go back to the integral, and maybe we can ask ourselves, can we integrate this by doing some integrations? Remember two things to deal with improper integrals. Know your integrations and believe in your limit. That's it, right? So now, we'll integrate that. And yes, I know, all the work that we did earlier did not help, right? So I have to erase it. And I wouldn't say it was a waste of time, because it was still good to show you guys sometimes the comparison theorem may not work. And you have to be careful with the criteria and also the check and things like that. Now, let's go ahead and focus on doing the integration right here. To integrate 1 over x squared minus 1, you see this right here, we can factor it, and we will. We'll factor this as x minus 1 times x plus 1. So that we can do partial fractions, right? This is going to be the same as the integral from 2 to infinity, And the first little fraction will be something over x minus 1, and then plus something over x plus 1 dx. This two was the limit of integration. This and that were the factors for that. Okay, so now, to figure out the number goes above the x minus 1, we go back to the original. I will cover this up, and I will ask myself, how can I make this factor 0? How can I make x minus 1 0? We have to let x is equal to 1, right? And I will plug in 1 into this x right there. So we will have 1 plus 1 on the bottom, which is 2. 1 over 2 then, for this number right here. And now we do the same thing. Here we have x plus 1. I need to figure this out. I go back to the original, and I will cover this up. How can I make this equal to 0? I have to make x equal to negative 1, right? We will have 1 over negative 1 minus 1, which is negative 1 half. Negative 1 half. And once again, this 2 is just from the limit of integration. So let me put down right there. So it has nothing to do with the factors, OK? All right, so just write it down nicely and carefully. OK, integration time. Let me put down the 1 over 2 first. And we have to integrate 1 over x minus 1. This is just a linear function. So we'll get ln absolute value of x minus 1. And have a good habit of checking the derivative. The derivative of x minus 1 is just 1. Dividing by 1 doesn't matter, so we're good. Next, we put down this number, minus 1 half. And we have to integrate 1 over x plus 1. And we'll also end up with ln, and in this case is absolute value of x plus 1, like this. Don't worry about the plus c, because we have to plug in this right here, right? And I'm doing the shorthand way, because whenever we're doing infinities right here, you have to technically write down the limit as some variable goes to infinity. But this is OK. I'm just going to write it down as bracket. I will just plug in 2 to infinity like this, OK? But you have to remember, whenever we have infinity in here, that means we are taking a limit. And let's go ahead and see that. This is going to give us, let me just show you guys a setup. I will plug infinity into here and here for the first right here. So we will have 1 half ln absolute value infinity minus 1, and then minus 1 half ln absolute value infinity plus 1. Right? That's the first plugging. And then we will subtract the second plugging, the 2, into all this x. We have 1 half ln absolute value 2 minus 1, and then minus 1 half ln absolute value of 2 plus 1, like all this. Pretty good so far, isn't it? And now let's see what do we end up with. Let's do the easy one first, if you guys don't mind. For example, 2 minus 1 is 1. Ln 1 is 0. 1 half times 0, this part right here is just 0, so we are good. And 2 plus 1 is 3, and ln 3 times 1 half is just, okay, let me write down. This is going to be minus 1 half ln. I don't need the absolute value because the 3 is passed inside, so I can put down ln parentheses 3 like this. And of course, we still have a negative all the way in front, but let me just indicate that right here for now. Let's look at this. It's trickier this way. Okay, infinity minus 1 is infinity. Ln infinity is infinity. 1 half times infinity is infinity. So altogether here is infinity. Let me bring down the minus. And by the way, when I put down infinity right here, I cannot say this diverges, because check this out right here, in the same bracket. Infinity plus 1 is infinity. Ln of infinity is infinity. Infinity times 1 half is infinity. So we have infinity minus infinity. We cannot draw any conclusion. In fact, this right here, we have to do more work, isn't it? This is indeterminate. It can be a finite value. It can be 0. It can still go to infinity. I don't know. So the deal is that we have to look at the whole thing right here and do more work. And be sure you supply the work on the side somewhere, OK? And let me just indicate that with a star here. And let me put this down on the side here. We have to work out this limit the legitimate way. So first, let's write down the lim as x, because right here, I was using x, right? As x goes to infinity, and we have this expression here, so let's put that down. We have 1/2 ln, and because x is going to pass infinity, you don't necessarily need to write down the absolute value. You can just write this down as parentheses, right? Because inside it's positive anyways. So x minus 1 inside like this, and then minus 1/2 ln, also, you know, just write it down as parentheses, x plus 1 like this. Okay, so this is the limit that we have to do on the side, and we have discussed this earlier already. When x is approaching infinity, this term is infinity, and this is also going to give us infinity. Infinity minus infinity, we have to do more work, right? That's why we're here. But to me, this infinity minus infinity situation is not so good because I cannot use L'Hopital's rule, right? So the strategy is, I'm going to somehow combine the terms together. I want to make this into either a 0 over 0 situation or an infinity over infinity situation, because that way I will be able to use L'Hopital's rule, okay? And to do so, first we can just factor out the 1/2 and use some law properties from there. So let me do that for you guys right here. This is going to be the limit as x goes to infinity, and I will factor out the 1/2, right? So that's okay. And you see, I put down that 1/2 right here. And then we will have ln of x minus 1, and then minus another ln, x plus 1. Ln minus ln, we can just do 1 ln and then do the first one over the second one, right? That's one of the logarithm property. So here we have ln, and let me put down big parentheses. Let me put this down on the top, which is x minus 1. And we will have an over, because earlier we had a subtraction, over that one, which is x plus 1, like this. Okay, so this is what we have now. At the moment, if you see it, infinity into x, on the top here we have infinity. On the bottom here, we also have infinity. But both of them are inside of the ln. And this is perhaps a more legitimate way to finish this stuff right here. Okay, so first of all, let me take the 1/2 out. Okay, and second of all, the deal is that when we're taking a limit of an ln, this is in fact the same as we take the ln of the limit. So I can put down the ln first and then put down the parentheses, and then we look for the limit as x goes to infinity, and the inside is x minus 1 over x plus 1, like this. Okay? So once again, I can take the constant multiple out. That's always the situation. Second, the limit of the ln, it's the same as the ln of a limit. Now, we will just have 1/2 in the front, that's good, and then still ln. And in this case, let's see, infinity minus 1 is infinity on top, infinity plus 1 is also infinity on the bottom. So technically, we have infinity over infinity now, we can use L'Hopital's rule, right? I will just do L'Hopital's rule right here and put on d dx and then put on d dx. On the top, you end up with 1. On the bottom, the derivative of x plus 1 is also 1. And then you see, we just have to do the limit as x goes to infinity of 1, isn't it? That's all we have to do. And this is 1/2 times ln. Inside here, you see nothing but just 1, so of course you have 1. And what's ln of 1? It's 0. So altogether here, this is equal to 0. Alright, so be sure you supply all the work right here on the side, especially if you are doing the exam or something like that. Anyways, this right here, the whole thing will give you 0, which is great. Right? And once again, be sure you show the legitimate way to do the limit right here, okay? Finally, we'll finish this up. This is just going to be 0, and this is also 0, but this term is negative inside of the parentheses. Negative times negative becomes positive. Finally, we have the answer 1/2, and then ln 3. And we are done. just like that. So therefore, does this converge or not? Yes, it converges because at the end, we have a finite value, right? So this right here converges, and that's it.